Spasmatic Supplements by Tim Muriello, premier top-level high-performance supplements designed specifically for hardcore lifters. From pre-workouts to branched-chain amino acids, test boosters, and pro-hormones, visit spasmaticsupplements.com. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Tim Muriello, Spasmatic Tim Muriello podcast. Thank you for joining us. So check it out, man. First off, man, I love doing these podcasts because, you know, with a video, oh my gosh, bro, it's such a freaking pain in the butt. Like, dude, I have to have my hair looking good, gotta be have a little decent shave going on, then gotta set up a nice little scene, and then gotta make sure my SD card has got plenty of room on it, and, you know, then I have to record it, make sure the lighting's good, the audio's good, record it, get it onto my computer, edit it. It's like, dude, it's such a freaking headache. I enjoy doing it, but, dude, definitely wanted to do a podcast because I think a podcast, man, there's just, you know, YouTube's so strict about certain things, man, and just podcasts are just so off the cuff. You know what I mean? Shoot from the hip. There's a current event going on. Boom. Get on your mic and relax and just chill with your listener. So check this out, man. I wanted to talk to you about something that I would say, and even now science is really pretty much saying it, that it's an epidemic. Now, listen, this is the people to our monitoring this podcast to make sure it's legit and I don't offend anybody. This podcast right here today is not, it's basically like an educational, informative, almost a scientific and highly unbiased video against anybody. So we're going to be tackling what I said science is basically calling a widespread occurrence of chemicals that are making our estrogen go through the dang roof. No, I'm not kidding. Literally, I saw this article that just that came out. And of course, you know, I've made some videos before about this on YouTube about how we're just so exposed to freaking crazy different chemicals. And what they're saying now is these chemicals are literally mutating animals. Nope. I said that right. It's literally mutating animals, bro. And it's having a bad effect on men. What are these chemicals? Well, I'm gonna tell you. Just wait. These chemicals are found in plastics. You know, you're making your food. You got your Tupperware. You put it in the microwave. Little did you know, your Tupperware container is not BPA free, and it's loaded with BPAs. Your cleaners. You literally pick up a Clorox wipe, you start wiping down your freaking counter, dude. Little did you know, you're handling and exposing yourself to estrogen rising chemicals that are literally affecting you. It's in the milk. You drinking milk. It's in your detergent for your clothes. They're found in plastic water bottles, all kinds of different plastics. Pesticides in your yard, pesticides on your fruit, in your freaking shampoo. They're called xenoestrogens, people. Xenoestrogens. And let me tell you what they do. They actually lower your testosterone. And I'm specifically talking about men here. They lower your testosterone and raise your estrogen levels. Now, let me tell you something, man. We are literally being bombarded with these chemicals. And there's like, oh, I feel like nothing you can freaking do about it as far as your exposure to these chemicals. Now, you know, man, I don't have to tell you, what does testosterone do? Well, testosterone basically, you know, it kind of creates your masculinity, right? That's what testosterone helps you become more of a masculine man. Obviously, during puberty, testosterone is freaking, that's huge. That's what helps you develop into manhood. What does estrogen do? Well, you probably know that too. Estrogen really helps women become feminine, right? So what's going on today? I can tell you what's going on. Men are literally drowning in estrogen. That's right. Because all these freaking chemicals and the plastics and shampoos and deodorants and all this other crap. We are literally overexposed to these chemicals that are making our estrogen go through the freaking roof. And don't take my word for it. They're actually, I just saw a study. Excuse me, I had to clear my nose here. Listen, I just saw a study that said that these chemicals that are all over us that we're just overly exposed to are actually affecting the puberty in boys and girls. Dude, I'm not kidding. And again, this is not a weird thing. It's not a derogatory thing. I mean, no, it's how about this? Just to be conservative so I don't get in trouble. This is a scientific viewpoint on this. Now, this study said that these chemicals that are making our estrogen levels rise to the roof are making young girls start puberty way earlier than they should. And these chemicals that are making our estrogen go through the roof are actually causing a delay in puberty in boys. This is really what you would call an estrogen epidemic. And I feel like what's going on is men generally in this country right now, and maybe across the world, that are exposed to these chemicals, these xenoestrogens, man, where you're gurgling with dang estrogen. I feel like it's making men not as masculine as they once were. I don't know. Am I wrong? Am I being stupid here? I feel it's true because it's just simple science. If you have too much estrogen and not enough testosterone in men, you're going to have depression, you're going to be anxious, you're going to be, there's a lot of problems. I can name a bunch, but there's a lot of problems when you have low testosterone and you're freaking swimming, immersed in absolute estrogen. So a company called ChemTrust, right? They did a study and they showed the reports of 250 studies. I'm gonna say that again. ChemTrust, company called ChemTrust, did a study and they brought in a collection, a compilation of over 250 studies specifically on the effects on humanity due to these chemicals that are swarming around us. You know what they called it? I thought it was freaking weird, dude. A little scary. They called it a widespread occurrence. And some of the species in the wilderness, right? In the wilderness and out in the wild or whatever, were actually, like, I think it was like frogs and cockroaches. These chemicals, due to the pollution, which is another one, man. There's pollution, you know, especially you live in like LA, dude. It's like smog, bro. And it's like estrogen raising, testosterone depleting smog, dude. And you are literally stuck in that freaking crap. Well, that pollution affects our wildlife. They were saying that these chemicals have actually been instrumental in turning frogs and roaches from male into female. Dude, that's wild. That's just wild. You know what I'm talking about? What do we do? Because I feel like you're screwed. When are you going to stop using cleaners and air fresheners and armpit deodorant and detergent? You know what I mean? Ain't nothing you can do, bro. You're stuck. The only thing you can do, really, right, is control your estrogen. Man, that's why I'm here on the podcast, bro. Okay, that's one of the things I'm trying to hit home with you is we have to control our estrogen. Should all men be on a daily anti-estrogen? I don't know, man. Maybe. I'll tell you this. I take anti-estrogens. Bro, I ain't freaking ashamed. I'll tell you right now, I take anti-estrogens, man. Because I know we live in an estrogen epidemic. I'll say it again. That's why I take anti-estrogens, man. I have high testosterone, and I know if you have high testosterone, your estrogen can climb up. It ain't about that life. And it ain't about xenoestrogens either. So here's the thing, man. I take anti-estrogens, maybe, I don't know, talk to your doctor. That might be something you want to look into, okay? Other things you can do, obviously, your plastics, man, you want to make sure your plastics are BPA-free. Shampoo, I use a shampoo that has no phthalates. That's a hard word to say, bro. If you saw the spelling of phthalate, I think it's like, if you saw the spelling, dude, it's a crazy word, bro. Phthalates. Phthalates are in your shampoo. You know what they do? They sink into your scalp and they raise your estrogen levels and suck the life-giving, masculine-forming testosterone straight out of your freaking soul, bro. Yes, sir. Yes, sir, man. Listen, man. Did I scare you? No, I mean, I honestly did not mean to scare you. I did. I want you to have a healthy scare, bro. Because listen, man. You know, and I'm saying this right way. If you're the type of person like myself, being masculine is a very important thing to you, right? Ain't it? Well, being masculine is very important to you, bro. I don't know. I would take the necessary precautions, you know? Dude, you know what's weird? I feel like a lot of people aren't talking about this. This is just freaking crazy because it's like widespread and wide scale. Take precautions, man. Hey, listen, that's really all I got right now. Thank you so much for listening to the podcast today. I'm going to be doing a lot of frequent podcasts on here. Make sure to check them out, baby. Hey, don't forget to check out spasmaticsupplements.com. All my supplements, including Gym Crush Cologne. That's right, I got a new cologne out. It's loaded with pheromones, loaded with a high dose of pheromones that actually appeals to a woman's attraction receptors. All right, man, real quickly, also wanted to tell you that I am going to be doing some more stand-up comedy. If you're in the Tampa Bay area, definitely come out. We'll see you then, guys.